It's been 2.5 years since Bambu Lab dropped an atomic bomb on the 3D printing industry, the X1 Carbon, and it seems like every other 3D printing brand is now releasing their own answer to it. And while it would be easy to dismiss each of these printers as a copycat of Bambu Lab, the reality is that each brand has also had the opportunity to learn from Bambu Lab, not just from what they've done right, but also what they've not. What's more, Bambu Lab is, at the time of this recording, currently embroiled in what is probably the biggest controversy in the company's short history. I feel like every single day when I open up YouTube or Reddit, I'm met with another video or post from someone new explaining why they will no longer be recommending or purchasing Bambu Lab printers and will instead be looking elsewhere. So when AnyCubic reached out and they asked to sponsor a video about the new Kobra S1 Combo, I asked them to let me do something a little bit different this time around. Instead of just giving you guys a boring 15 to 20 minute overview of the printer and all of the features that it offers that ultimately would feel like an infomercial, I asked them to let me do something that honestly, most brands would never let me do. Compare it to Bambu Lab. Now, hold on before you get too excited or get out your bowl of popcorn. Again, this is a sponsored video, not a review, because there is a conflict of interest. And plus, the brand does need to sign off on this video at the end of the day. So while I would never ever say anything in any of my videos that I don't feel to be true, and my opinions cannot be bought, this is not a review. Don't expect to hear me singing the praises of either brand, picking a winner, or talking about the shortcomings of the Kobra S1 in this video. I'll be providing that kind of feedback directly to the brand, but do let me know in the comments below if you would like to see me do a separate unbiased review of this machine once I've had a little bit more time with the final version of its software and profiles. Instead, I propose that in this video, we just stick to the facts. Let's take an honest, close look at this machine and ask the questions. What features are actually unique here? What are they doing differently? And in what ways might this printer actually improve on the quantum leap created by Bambu Lab? Let's get after it. First and foremost, given that the current controversy surrounding Bambu Lab surrounds the whole support for third-party apps like Orca Slicer thing, I do want to actually start this video out by addressing what AnyCubic is doing in that regard. Yes, the Kobra S1 uses its own firmware and its own cloud services like Bambu Lab. However, AnyCubic was very quick to point out to me when I met them at Formnext that they have now openly embraced Orca Slicer, and they're actually releasing a totally new version of their own slicer, which is now a fork of Orca Slicer. Now, this in turn means that it is very easy to port the profiles over to Orca Slicer if you prefer to use that, like I do. But we do have no word yet on whether or not you'll be able to send directly from Orca Slicer to the printer, as that functionality is only coming in the next release of AnyCubic's new slicer. Hopefully, and I'm definitely passing this along to AnyCubic as well, this is one big way that AnyCubic can really differentiate themselves by really embracing the overwhelmingly popular Orca Slicer and allowing it very deep integration into their own LAN mode and cloud slicing mode. Fingers crossed here, and I would love if you guys comment below if you agree with me that they should definitely do that. Up next, let's go to the big, obvious, and low-hanging fruit. AnyCubic's Ace Pro, like the Ace on the Kobra 3, has a built-in filament dryer. It can be used as a standalone filament dryer, it can dry the filament while you're actually printing, or it can even schedule the print to only start once the current filament drying cycle is over. Now, I know that I said I wouldn't insert my own opinions or commentary here, but I think you guys can agree that this is objectively a fantastic feature, and believe it or not, it's actually a feature that nobody besides AnyCubic has right now. And seriously, why not? I mean, probably the biggest value add to having an enclosed printer like this one is the ability to print more exotic materials, things like nylon or polycarbonate. But without the ability to actually dry those materials while you're printing them, you either have to be really on top of keeping your filament dry all the time, which I'm not, or plan ahead 8 hours and dry them before you actually need them.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
What's more, when you consider the price of this machine, which we'll get into at the end, and the fact that a similar four-spool filament dryer can easily cost $130, this, in my opinion, is one of the major standout features that really sets this combo apart from everything else on the market. And I'm honestly quite shocked that other contenders aren't already offering it. But the multi-material system upgrades and improvements definitely don't end there. As you probably already know, one of the biggest complaints or shortcomings with the original Bambu Lab AMS was the reliability of filament loading, causing many people to go out and design or print their own modifications or upgrades. One of the key issues seemed to be the angle of the Bowden tube when the printer's glass lid was on, causing it to repeatedly load and unload. Well, AnyCubic has solved this, interestingly enough, with some 3D printed parts, which gradually change the angle of the PTFE tube as it goes into the toolhead, probably because there was no off-the-shelf accessory to go with the cable chains that they're using. So far, in my experience, it works quite well and it never has an issue loading filament. Another thing that they've done to improve reliability during load and unload is to add these fins inside of the actual ace, which keep the spools straight and prevent them from rocking side to side, especially when you're using lightweight cardboard spools or spools that are nearly empty. I also like the fact that I don't need two hands to load filament into the Ace Pro. It auto-detects when I'm inserting the filament and grabs it from me, rather than me needing to push away the gear to actually load it. And I know that's something a lot of people were printing improvements for the Bambu Lab AMS. But wait, because there's actually more before we move on to the printer itself. AnyCubic has done something pretty smart with the splitter and buffer situation, which actually Bambu Lab themselves also did on their own follow-up to the AMS, which was the AMS Lite. Instead of housing the 4-to-1 splitter under the AMS mechanisms where it's a huge hassle to access if filament breaks, they are sending out all four filaments from the back of the AMS and merging them closer to the printhead. Then, instead of having one buffer, they've actually put a buffer on each of the paths. Now, these changes not only make it much easier to clear broken filament out, but I would imagine they also will yield more reliability long term. It also should, in theory, allow for faster color changes because the filament has a much shorter path to travel every time you change colors. But I think probably AnyCubic has some optimization to do there in the future in terms of timing and speed. But okay, enough about the Ace Pro. Let's now talk about the printer itself. One thing that I think was a shortcoming of the Bambu Lab X1 and P1 series was the nozzle changing process. It's two screws, it's three plugs, anytime that you want to do something as simple as change a nozzle. Now, this resulted in a plethora of quick change systems coming on the market for those printers, and Bambu Labs themselves actually fixing that and upgrading the process to something much better in the A1 series. AnyCubic, for their part, has also created a quick swap system, which involves a simple flick of a lever, unplugging one connector, and you can remove the entire hot end. That does, of course, mean that you'll want to keep compatible, fully assembled hot ends on hand if you want true fast swaps, but it honestly beats looking for an Allen key and removing two screws. Another thing that I actually like is the way that the toolhead cover attaches. It did take some getting used to figure out where to apply pressure to remove it, and it's really on there. But once you do figure it out, you realize that it is a much more sturdy connection. Personally, I've had a lot of prints stop in the middle on my Bambu Lab printers because the tool head comes off when it gets caught on a little piece of errant poop that didn't quite make it down the chute. And it makes you wonder if a cover that is traveling at such high speeds and accelerations really should be attached magnetically. Now, this one might be a little bit divisive. I think you either love it or hate it. But I feel like the industry as a whole is moving away from glass panels, and it's honestly anyone's guess as to why. Some companies are putting anti-shatter coatings on the glass or adding friction hinges, and others are eschewing glass altogether, going for sturdy, indestructible plastic. AnyCubic has opted for the latter here, both on the top lid and on the front door. And I, for one, welcome the change. Acrylic panels can definitely look cheap sometimes, but this one is actually molded with rounded corners and a thick bevel, which take advantage of the benefits that plastic can offer, which glass cannot. And I don't know about you guys, I think it looks pretty great. Now, you might think that the lower mass of the plastic panels would then result in more noise coming through the printer, but while I was writing this video, I actually realized that this printer is much quieter than any of my Bambu Lab X1 or P1 machines. I had this one running right behind me in the studio while I was writing the script, and I had a P1S in the other room with the door open, and I actually could hear the P1S making more noise than the S1. And honestly, not just the motors either. The fans seem to be quieter on here, even with the filament dryer running. And a recent software update even made the loading and unloading of the Ace Pro quieter as well. Another thing that I appreciated when setting up the S1 was the carbon air filtration. One of my original gripes the first time I tried out the X1 Carbon was that it didn't live up to its name, carbon, in terms of using the carbon for filtration. A problem that they later fixed by tweaking the ABS and ASA profiles. But still, the Bambu Lab machines have a really, really small amount of carbon for filtration compared to this machine, which results in pretty strong ABS smells while printing those types of materials. And they also want you to buy the carbon cartridges from them, though I always just print my own. This printer just uses a nice generic baggie of activated charcoal, and as a result, it seems to do a much better job filtering out the stank. But disclaimer here, I'll admit that I've only done a couple ABS or ASA prints compared to doing thousands of hours on the Bambu Lab machines. Here's another one that is pretty interesting, the touchscreen. I'm sure you know that the P1S, which is the most comparable to this machine in price, though not in features, as we'll cover in a second, it's widely panned for having a 90s car stereo display for a user interface. Also, for recently threatening to lock down the protocol that allowed users to add their own aftermarket touchscreen upgrades. The S1, on the other hand, has a large touchscreen akin to that of the X1 Carbon, and it pivots all the way from 0 to 90 degrees. I actually haven't seen this on any other printer, and I suspect that AnyCubic wants to capture some of that sweet print farm market that Bambu Lab has become so dominant in, and they're adding features like this to get the screen out of the way or the rugged plastic top and door for farm owners who put their machines floor to ceiling on racks and don't want things that can get knocked. Which reminds me, another thing that this machine offers at this price point that Bambu Lab actually relegates onto the pricier X1 Carbon is AI failure detection. Unfortunately, I don't think that I've had the opportunity to test this yet. I don't know if it's been running, but I suspect that it is coming on a future firmware update. I also haven't had the opportunity because I've only had one print failure, but it will be here when they release it. All right, another small thing that you probably wouldn't notice if you weren't looking for it. The Kobra S1 can actually print at 320C and heat the bed all the way to 120C. If you compare that to the 300 and either 100 or 110 of the Bambu Lab X1 Carbon, you'll find that this machine is in fact more capable in terms of printing exotic materials like nylon, PPACF, Tullamer, PCCF, and more. But of course, all of that is going to be dependent on the availability of hardened steel or diamond hot end upgrades. So Fadis, E3D, Diamondback, if you're watching. Now, before we get to the price, one more silly little thing that I just wanted to bring up. I noticed that AnyCubic's app uses the app clip feature on iOS, which to my knowledge, no other printer manufacturer does yet. It's a silly little thing, but it's been really, really nice to be able to check on the print status of this printer right from the lock screen without having to unlock my phone. And I'd really like to see other manufacturers implement this. I have it on Mobile Raker, so I can do it for my Vorons and other Clipper printers, but this is the only off-the-shelf printer that I've been able to do it for, and it's a really nice feature. And now, the final and perhaps the biggest differentiating feature, the price. The Kobra S1 is currently on sale for $469, down from a retail price of $549. As a combo with the Ace Pro, you're looking at $629, down from a retail price of $749. Those prices are $120 to $130 less than the Bambu Lab P1S or P1S combo, and they're a staggering $630 to $720 off from the Bambu Lab X1 Carbon, which given the touchscreen, the AI print failure detection, and the much higher temperatures, might honestly be a fairer comparison. Again, not a review, I can't give an endorsement here just yet, I need a lot more time on this machine. But those savings are objectively pretty staggering, and it makes it pretty clear to me that AnyCubic is gunning hard for Bambu Lab. Even when the pre-sale is over, these printers are going to be significantly more affordable than the P1S and certainly the X1 Carbon. And I think that is going to be a deciding factor both for people on a budget and for print farms looking to pick up dozens of machines. Do feel free to use my link in the description. It costs you nothing, but it does help the channel out. With that said, it's not enough of a reward that I would sway my opinion or say anything I don't feel to be true about this machine. In any case, I hope all of you have found this video interesting. I know that it's easy right now to dismiss a lot of the new printers coming out as Me Too or copycats, but I personally found it very interesting to see how these brands are striving to stand out and what they're learning and improving upon. Obviously, each one of these companies has teams and teams of engineers trying to figure out how to capture back market share from the other companies in the space. And I do think it's fascinating to see which problems they've identified with the current market leaders and how they've gone about solving those problems. I'd love to hear what all of you think in the comments below and what you thought about this video. I'm really trying to stop being influenced by the types of videos that sponsors would ideally like me to do, and instead focus on different ways that I can create the most valuable content for all of you guys. And I welcome feedback in that regard. On that note, I do want to give a huge thank you and shout out to Ilsa from AnyCubic for letting me do this video my way and giving me more creative freedom than brands often like to do. So thank you, Ilsa, and comment below if you guys also appreciated that. That's all for this week, but I'll see all of you on the next layer.